Hello and welcome to a very, very special program. Well, you've all heard about the fantastic success of the Chandrayaan mission. Just a few years back, none of us would really have thought that India will one day put a satellite around the moon. Well, we have done that, and we've done so successfully. It's all part of a team effort led by a remarkable group of individuals. They are some of India's finest scientists, engineers, and project managers. And joining us on this program, pretty much the who's who of ISRO. Now, a very warm hand of applause for all of them joining us on this program. And as we introduce all of these individuals, perhaps the most defining aspect of all of them is that besides being fantastic scientists and engineers, they're also individuals who are singularly humble, singularly dignified, and we'll come to know a little bit more about them throughout this program. For starters, Dr. Madhavan Nair, he's the chairman of ISRO. When he was a young child, his grandmother once told him that she promised him the moon. Now he's in the business of bringing the moon to all of us. Dr. Radhakrishnan is the director of the Vikram Sarabhai Space Center at Thiruvananthapuram. When he's not dreaming about stars and the moon, because they're all dreaming about the moon these days, he sings, he also dances a bit of Kathakali. Dr. M. Annadurai is the project director of Chandrayaan 1. He is very much the brains behind the day-to-day operations of Chandrayaan. But did you know that that man had not seen a streetlight till he was 7 years old? Now he is so important in this Chandrayaan project. A very warm hand of applause once again for these three individuals. And two more key individuals at ISRO right now. George Koshy is the mission director of the Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle. It's all very good to have a satellite like Chandrayaan, but we can't actually chuck it into space. We need a rocket to get it up there, and that's what he was doing. But perhaps he has the skills to actually throw something up in space as well, because when he's not thinking about rockets, he's playing basketball all the time. And also joining us, Professor J.N. Goswami. He's the chief scientist of Chandrayaan 1 and director of the Physical Research Laboratory in Ahmedabad. His wife has a big problem. He works too hard. He works for 365 and a quarter days every single year and just doesn't have time for anything other than the moon project. Well, also joining us, firstly, from Bangalore, Wing Commander Rakesh Sharma. He is perhaps the most famous person associated with the Indian space program, the first Indian in space. Wing Commander, thanks very much for being with us. And Mallika Sarabhai also joins us. She joins us from Ahmedabad. She is one of India's finest dancers. But a lot of you may not have known that she's the daughter of the late Dr. Vikram Sarabhai, the father of the Indian space program. Thanks, man. Thanks very much for being with us on the show today. Dr. Nair, to you first. As a little child, did you ever imagine that you would one day be in a position to lead a team of Indians who've developed a craft that goes around the moon?
Well, I think it would be extremely difficult to imagine such thing those days. The most sophisticated device I have seen those days was a bullock cart. So you can imagine how far one can stretch the imagination. But still, I was fascinated looking at the mountain, the skies, and so on. And maybe that imagination has led all the way up to the...
So far. But tell us, Dr. Radhakrishnan, one of the most defining aspects of ISRO as a whole is the fact that you have so much homegrown talent, that a lot of the individuals actually who are with us in this room are not necessarily people who've traveled abroad or have been part of some space program in another country. They are Indians educated at regional colleges who decided to stay on in the country and contribute to a program because they felt for it.
See, when I finished my engineering degree, on the same day I got interview call from two places. One was from Tumba, other was one from IBM. Of course, lucrative salary. I went to my professor and asked what I should do. He told me in Tumba there is a satellite launch vehicle project they are planning to have.